Ranos here, and welcome to the episode of Space Engineers, where we're taking a look at some compact grinders and welders and a drill. Picture over there. Both updated by Dead Phoenix. When I say updated, I mean he quite literally just updated to work with the current version of the game. So let's go take a look by going first person. Whee! Action hauler right in the back. Yeah, that poor thing's not gonna be able to fly now. Anyway, with this version of all of these, they have large conveyors on the side rather than the back. Although in this one, they do have these smaller conveyors on the back. Which, the mod maker of this particular pack also made a conveyors to go with it. So, you know, you got something useful. And who was the one who made it? Well, Ravenbolt and that like said Cred 23 Rick, odd name, but well. And this version, the laser welders, was created by Weaver, updated to DX11 by The Witch, and updated to the current version of Space Engineers by Dead Phoenix. Let's go for a lot of versions. Yeah, I'm only going to include a link to Dead Phoenix's update page of this mod. Same with that one. Because if you want to go see the previous versions, then there are links on that page. So you can easily find them. Now, that's a drill. Works just as a normal drill, but that bit spins. If I set it on now, it'll probably destroy a lot of things. Let's do it! Where's I gotta put a button on? I forgot to put the button on. Not that one. I need this one. So surprisingly it's doing no damage. Okay then. I guess only things in front of it will take damage? Yeah, probably. It's actually pretty good for like sticking on the side of thin bots. Well, ships. And here we have the wide, medium, and narrow. Well, near. Wait, yeah, far, medium, near. You gotta see it from here. And yep, far, medium, and near. Far one, and off. Oh, you're just grinding. Bugger. Start grinding up this bit. I need to turn this on and give myself a welder. Nope, not that one. And welder. The heck was it grinding? Whoa. Yeah, you see, it's got all the way out here. The far one. Wow, that is far. Yeah. I see, and then each one will just be closer and closer. So that will actually be quite helpful when dismantling ships and that. Though you have all three of them at the same time, then oh my, it's a lot of grinding. Now it works the same here with near, medium, and far. However, for this one, I got a bit of a demonstration set up. So first, we'll go for near. I hope I get the right one. Yeah, that's a near. Boop. Whee. Now. Well. As far as it gets. What's happening? Anyway, turn it off. And do that. And that's as much as it can do. Although we'll probably do more at the bottom, but, you know. Limitations. Anyway, time for the next one. Boom. See, it does that much. The shaking is really weird. How's that to do with the mods, though? Yeah, you get quite a bit of distance on the next one. And, as we expected, the last one's going to have the greatest of distances. And on. Ah, it's not going to show me. How about if I place that there? No. There. No. There. No. There. There we go! And you see, it gets quite far there too. Turn you off. Not sure what all the shaking's about. Pretty sure I turned tool shaking off. Meh, well, never mind. You see, you get welding done in various distances. Although, they seem to have a minimum and a maximum distance. Which isn't too bad. So you have like three of these all packed together, you can weld any distance, really. Yeah, I think having three of them all packed up together will actually be a good idea. But maybe if you want to do some like a ship that only does like long range welding, that could be a good one. It means you don't have to get too close. And it'll also be helpful for welding up blocks that are deeper into the ship. And, unfortunately, this is now in the way of that one. So, we have to do some deleting. And... debunk. And... debunk. And finally, debunk. Need to turn mirroring off. So, a pretty good range of those ones. I believe the range of effectiveness is the same as these. So that was actually a good visualization of its range. I bet you moved over there. Oh well, I'm right. So first, I'm going to start with the near one. That's this one. Thank you. Let's turn it up. Yeah, that's the one we want. We want that one first. Don't know why I made it so far out. What? Hey, that was a bit unexpected, to be honest. So, yeah. Let's do the whole forward offset here. And... no. No. Probably not. Okay then. I think their range is a bit further than this. Nope. Maybe nope. There we go. And that's the near one. Okay, the range of these ones is going to be insane. Well, let's go turn that one off. That's not the one I want on. And there we go. Next, we'll go for the middle one. Whee! Oh yeah, that's the far one. We're getting closer and closer as we make these. Stop vibrating like a nutter now. Anything. And let's stand on this side. Activate that one. And activate that one. Deep. Turn them off. Don't know why the hell the place shakes like a mentalist. So yeah, I think you can actually... the range differences are much greater for this set than they are that set. Other than that, they work pretty much the same. That just has a more of a vanilla look to it. Well, old vanilla look to it. Again, he's an update to his models. Oh well. Whee! I believe that one may use up more energy. You know, because it's like a laser welder. Who knows? And that's all there is to go over with it, really. Because I think that has like the same range one as a novel drill. Ah yes, they're all recolorable, so you don't have to worry about that. But anyway, I think we should end this one here. And links for both these mods will be in the description below. And I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.